Hello and welcome to my critical reflection video for guerrilla filmmaking. My name is Jordan Gregory and I responded to the What Is Home, the Animals and the Letter to a Loved One challenge. I made the films in that order, so I'll discuss them in that order for convenience. With each one I'll talk about how I made the film, why I made it that way, problems that arose, how I screened the film, and then at the end I'll discuss some of the ways that I feel the module has helped me and what it has taught me. So the first film that I made was in respondent to the What Is Home question, and the challenge was to make a film that does not feature any moving images. And so I made this. So how did I make the film? Well, originally I had a different idea. I read the challenge at Christmas when I was going home. So I went home with my DSLR and I took a load of photographs of, you know, what resembled my hometown of Grimsby. And then when I came back to London, I took a load of photographs of what made me think of London. But I had this idea about contrasting, you know, these two different homes. But I decided that I felt a million other people have done something similar. Not to say that doesn't mean it could be good, but I wanted to try something different. So I scrapped that idea, and then 1 week we watched Year of the Nail. It's made with still images and this fluid audio, and that was kind of, I thought, oh, I might try and emulate that. So one day after a lecture, I went to the library and I wrote a script, a short two-page script, blah, blah, blah. And then I did a shot list and a storyboard. Called my friend Lawrence. I was like, yo, man, I'm gonna make a film if you wanna be in it. The way that I made it was, start with an establishing shot, but instead of recording video, and you know on the DSLR, your shutter speed, normally you press it's like, but I changed the shutter speed to continuous, so when I held it down, it goes, taking loads and loads and loads of photographs. Because it's not recording audio, I would read out the script first, told him to act it out very slowly. So it's like, yo, he's moving like this, and it's going, and did that from loads of different angles. And then once that was done, I got him to act the whole thing out again, but I, using my music making software, I just put my microphone on and recorded sound in the room. And then when I put them together, you had this, you know, choppy stop motion animation video with a fluid sound. So what problems arose? Firstly, I'd never tried to make a stop motion animation before, so it was an experiment for me. But that was kind of the idea with most of my films. I wanted them all to be an experiment, or at least try something new. I kind of looked at the module as an opportunity to do that. I didn't know how it was going to turn out, so there was a solid chance that it was going to look rubbish. Continuity was difficult at times, so like I said, when you're holding down the, so I'd have to tell him to stop every time the shutter speed started to lag. So every now and then we'd be acting a part out and it would go a little bit too far. And then I'd have to be like, oh, I think we were about here. And then sometimes there's big gaps in the images, so the continuity sometimes was a little out. Another problem was there was 7,500 images. So managing that and editing that was a little bit of a struggle, to be honest. Why did I make the film this way? I got the idea for the film on the same week as we watched Year of the Nail, so Jonas Cuaron, and I think that had a, you know, that played a big influence, just because I thought it was kind of cool the way it was, the audio that really sort of like made the film feel fluid. Yeah, so I took that idea and just thought maybe it'd be cool if I did the same but with a lot more images, so it's just a bit more, you know, like a stop motion animation. As far as getting a reception for the video, I showed quite a few of my friends and then I screened it in class and, you know, got some positive feedback. I remember some people were recommending maybe I could manipulate the images more. So the second video that I made was in response to the animals challenge, in which it said to make a film that does not feature any synchronization between image and sound about animals. So I made this. How did I make this? Again, originally I did have another idea. I was going to make quite a graphic anti-meat industry kind of video. I'll show you a little bit, it's horrible. Rich, here's what she said to me. Que sera, sera. When I'd made that, I showed some of the guys who I lived with and they were like, oh, that's horrible. And it was meant to be horrible, that was the idea, but then kind of felt that it was trying a little bit too hard, and I'm not really, that's not really my style. pushing things, you know, explicitly onto people. So I just kind of decided, no, I'm going to try something different. I decided I was going to make a sort of nature documentary. I've got this book on birds, the RSPB, and it's got all this cool information about birds. I was thinking about making a short 2-3 minute bird documentary. So I went out with my DSLR and my tripod and a backpack full of bird seed and bread. And I just went around Richmond Park and the Roehampton area, and I would set up a tripod, chuck some bread and some seed or whatever else, and I'd just sit and wait. And I was going to make a serious nature documentary, but also around that time, and I just found out that on GarageBand you can actually import your videos, and you can actually watch films and play music along, so you can make soundtracks and stuff. So I was toying around with that. I just started like making, every time the birds moved, I'd put like a little sound in. I just thought it was kind of funny, and I thought, yeah, actually, this is quite entertaining. So what problems arose? So I couldn't make the animals do what I wanted them to do, so it was a lot of finding the right place to put the camera. Especially with the crows, they were very apprehensive. I was there for a good hour or two just having to be patient because they did not want to go anywhere near the camera. It was quite difficult to do the sound effects, like maybe more than it actually looks. The amount of time it took me to put all the little sounds in for it, because I had to focus on one animal at a time, make it look like it was them, their movements. So it was fiddly, but it was worth it. So with bird sounds, I actually put it on Facebook as soon as I made it, because I thought it was quite entertaining. I got some good reception. I don't know how many views exactly or anything like that, but I think it was about 60 people liked it. And you know, I had a lot of people commenting saying that they thought it was quite funny. Why make the film this way? Well, originally, I was, like I said, I was trying to make a serious nature documentary. I felt that to make a good one in 3 minutes, I needed to do more research and film more. And then, like I said, I found out about the importing into GarageBand, and things came into place, and I just went with it. The last film, Letter to a Loved One, which the challenge was to make an experimental animated or found footage film that takes the form of a letter to a loved one. And so I made this one. Stop making excuses, giving up and walking away from everything that stresses you out. Calm your tits, take a breath and think things through before you act, or there's going to be some big regrets. How did I make this film? I went home at Christmas before the module started, and my grandparents showed me a video that my dad and my mum had taken from when me and my sister were very young, and they put that up on the telly, at home footage of me and my family and stuff from 20 years ago. I thought that was really cool, so I couldn't actually get a copy of the DVD, but I just recorded it with my iPhone, recorded the screen. I decided that I wanted to make something a little more sentimental, and I thought about how cool it would be if you could go back in time and tell yourself, you know, you shouldn't do this and you shouldn't do that, and that's where I kind of got the idea to write a letter to my younger self. So basically I had this found footage, and I put that on top of lots of footage that I'd taken from recent history, just kind of like travelling, you know. And then I wrote a letter to myself. I imagined I was talking to myself 10 years in the past, and then in the background as well you can hear a little bit of nice like melancholy guitar. I just was playing a few chords. I thought it kind of sounded kind of dreamy. As far as problems that arose, trying to write the letter so it was sincere, but knowing that other people were going to hear it. But what I did is I just kept writing the letter over and over again. I think I did 4 or 5 different copies, and had my housemates listen to it. So yeah, to the reception, what I did is I just kept showing close housemates, had them listen to it, and they told me what they thought about it, and then I would go back and change stuff. So really it was the voiceover that just kept getting changed over and over again until I felt that it was sincere, but not too cringy. And why did I make the film this way? I liked the idea of this film being like a time capsule, like if it was actually possible to shoot it back through time, what would I actually say? It just had me thinking about that. And then the last thing before, just to conclude this video, what kind of things do I feel like I've learned from the module? One of the things I've learned is how diverse filmmaking can be, and how there are so many different ways that you can actually make a film, especially with the in-class screenings. You know, some of these films I'd never even thought about filmmaking in that sense before. You know, like Year of the Nail, especially. I really enjoyed Kid Icarus. You know, this idea of it was like a, the whole thing for me was like a reminder of, yes, filmmaking is difficult, and you know, you can look an absolute idiot making films, but if you want to be a filmmaker, you've got to make films, and you've got to be brave enough to acknowledge that you might look like a tit. I guess the whole module was kind of a little bit like a play on the Lars von Trier's The Five Obstructions, where, you know, restrictions, you know, rules and laying down boundaries kind of, they don't inhibit creativity, they can actually help it flourish. But yeah, no, it's been great. I think that's all I have to say. I hope that this has been informative and not too boring. And thank you for listening, and goodbye.